What is the hottest accent to have?
What was the worst haircut or hairstyle you've ever had?
How good are you at keeping secrets?
Ooh. Ooh.
Hello, Dan and Phil Games, sleeping bags.
ASMR warning. What? Where did that come from?
I was going for the sleepy energy.
Me. That revolted me.
It's the evening. We're ready for bed.
Look at us. We're pajammied up. We got the squishies. We've made hot cocoa.
Mm. Mine is white chocolate and raspberry flavor. Yours is amaretto. Dan's getting lit.
Strap in, people, because today we're going deep. Now, we have established that we know each other way too well.
Yeah.
We have heard everything about each other other than these bizarre childhood anecdotes that Phil keeps dropping.
They're never ending.
Is there anything that we don't know about each other at this point?
I think we can dig deeper. And the way we're going to do it
is via the help of a card game, because making conversation is hard. Forming thoughts, difficult. Being interesting, yikes. Right. So from the people that brought us...
This is a horrible
game. Phil.
Hey, Noel. Fishting. No!
Slight vibe shift here.
Yeah.
This one's Let's Get Deep.
Let's Get Deep.
Friends edition.
Expand your knowledge about your friends by asking and answering engaging questions from three increasingly personal levels.
Oh, increasingly personal.
Icebreaker, deep.
Ooh.
And deeper.
Daddy!
What was that? I've already got my security seal.
The challenge is, are me and Phil, or let's be honest, you guys parasocially with us at this point, gonna learn anything new?
I'm interested.
Are there depths that are yet to be plumbed?
And the question is, how deep can we go? And as we mentioned last time, these guys sent us a whole bunch of their games, so thanks for sponsoring us.
And if you want this, you can click the link in the description to get it for yourself.
We're in pajamas because we figured this game has a kind of slumber party energy.
We're getting the girlies together.
Yeah. Do you know that time at 4 a.m. when you're all in your sleeping bags?
No, not 4. This is like the 12:48 time.
It was 4 a.m. for me.
This is when you're asking the deep questions. It's 4:30 when it's finished and someone's crying and like Jeremy's broken up with Brenda, and then someone's done a poo on the floor and you're gonna call them Poo Floor Jeremy until they're 28.
I don't know what your slumber parties were like, but mine were a lot more civilized. We all played Mortal Kombat for 4 hours, then
civilized.
At 4 a.m, we'd be in our sleeping bags.
The sleepover started at 12.
Then someone would be like, do you think God is real? And then you just talk about it for like an hour.
And that is the energy that we're trying to cultivate right now. Okay, you ready to break the ice? Oh my God, this awkward tension between us right
gosh.
Now. I don't even know what to say. God, this is just so annoying.
Icy wall.
Ask me an icebreaker, go.
Fist through it. Daniel.
Yes.
To break the ice.
Go.
What is the hottest accent to have?
Irish.
Irish?
100%.
I mean, it is a hot accent.
It's by far the hottest accent.
Yeah.
I mean, there's lots like... Most European ones are quite sexy, right?
Yes.
Apart from, I'm not going to say that. Imagine a hot Irish boy talking to you. Jesus Christ.
Oh. I like Italian. I think Italian's a pretty hot accent as well. Do you know,
know they're hot. There's something about the Irish that are like understated.
Can you believe that, Daniel? What are you thinking about?
Sign language is my most attractive accent now. You completely ruined it.
I went on a very messy holiday to Portugal with my friends when we were 18. And then we found an Irish bar. And then there was a singer there called Colm.
Because when you want an authentic Irish experience, you go to the Irish pub.
Yeah, but everyone fancied the freaking Irish singer. So for the whole holiday, we didn't go anywhere else to drink. We just sat.
Everyone was just sat
staring at him.
Parasocial staring at the singer at this bar.
And then he stared at one of my friends very intensely on the floor of a car park behind a behind a bin.
Good for her. I assume a her.
It was a
her. Okay.
I wish it was me.
Phil, what celebrity crushes did you have growing up?
Oh, Daniel, let me have a think.
I'm putting an immediate blockade on that.
I'm sorry. Early crushes before I even knew I was a gay.
Just like an unknowable attraction.
Leonardo DiCaprio, Titanic. I was just like...
It's an extreme basic bitch
the boyish
answer,
charm.
And yet it makes so much sense.
Billy from Gremlins.
What about that?
I don't know. He was a nerd next door, but he cared for Gizmo so much. And I was like, I want to be Gizmo. I want to be in your pocket. As I got older, obviously Ryan Phillippe's moment getting out of the pool in Cruel Intentions.
Full ass reveal.
Ass reveal.
That's formative.
That made me gay. I wasn't gay before that.
That's the moment where it's like, if you hadn't realized now, we're gonna break the dam. We're gonna rip the plaster off. Like, right now is when you just need to accept
it. He got that peach out.
That's just the icebreaker, guys.
Yeah.
We're not going any deeper there.
No.
We're not gonna ask any questions. Right, one more. Go on, hit me. I'm still feeling mildly frosty because you're doing the Irish accent. Go.
Okay. What was the worst haircut or hairstyle you've ever had?
Fuck off. Shut up.
Do you even have to ask it? Let's remove square hair.
Yeah, okay. No, I've got a good one. Right, so emo's a thing. Emo was 2004.
Right.
Scene Kids was like 2005, 6. What's the difference? Could be blonde,
yeah.
Raccoon stripes. I'll tell you what the main thing
was. I remember the stripes.
Lead singer of Enter Shikari, straight fringe.
Just fully straight across.
Covering the eyes.
Oh.
I, as a cringe nerd 15-year-old, went to my local hairdresser, which was not like a cool alternative. It wasn't a barbershop. It was not a hair salon. It was like someone's mum with some scissors.
Yeah.
And I showed them this photo and she was like, what the fuck? Because obviously,
well, they're not gonna have done that.
They look like a goddamn chicken. What the hell's going on?
Yeah.
So she gave me a bowl cut.
Oh no.
Because
oh no.
What else was I asking for?
I know.
Yes, I want it to be a straight fringe. And she was like, are you sure you want it to be a straight fringe? And my mum came to pick me up from the shopping centre and I cried in the car on the way home.
What did you do? Did you get it fixed?
I just moved it around. I took a photo from a MySpace angle where I went. And then I put the most insane airbrushing you've ever seen on it. It would be framed in a museum if I still had it. Phil, if you could unproblematically have any exotic animal as a pet, what would you want?
Oh my God, what was that thing we saw the other day? It unlocked something with
the TikTok that you showed me.
Check out these awesome binturongs.
Indonesian bear cat.
It was an otter cat.
Bear.
Bear. Bitch, we're gonna mix them all together. What the hell is that?
People talk of the Mandela effect, but that animal definitely did not exist until I saw it.
Okay, the ice is broken.
Filter-on.
I feel loose.
That's because you've got an alcoholic hot chocolate.
Wow, all the chocolate was attached to the spoon and I just licked the spoon.
Was it? That
bro,
dense.
I'm in Narnia right now. What? Bleh.
Dan.
Yep.
It's time to go deep.
Will it be deep for us?
I don't know.
I mean, Jesus Christ. I'm ready, Phil. Hit me with something deep that I'm
not ready
for.
I hope this is deep. Play a round of fuck, marry, kill. Player who pulled the card chooses the people.
All right, and you know what? People always, they get all like, oh, I can't with this. Whatever you say, I'm just gonna do it right now, go.
I think this game can be mean. That's why I don't like it too much. So, I know what to do.
What if it's like your ugly friend, your pretty friend, and your person your girlfriend hates? Yeah, it can be a
I don't like it when people
mess
do that.
Vehicle. Don't be weird.
So
you have to make it fun.
Yes.
By either making it impossible or offensive. You know what I mean? Like it has to be disgusting.
Go on. Trump, Rishi Sunak, and Putin.
Ah!
Now
oh my God!
They're knocking at the door.
Wait, no. Let me think. Okay, right.
Don't arrest us. This is a game.
Okay.
Government, this is a game.
I'm gonna Putin.
Okay.
Because the worst.
I feel like we can't say this on YouTube.
Can
you just say I'm gonna K? Just
we want to TikTok a fire. How do we TikTok it? Oh my God! I'm gonna K
unalive.
Putin.
Oh my God!
I'm gonna unalive. P star.
There we go. Thank you. I don't want you to be on a list.
I cannot say that I'd fuck Trump.
Okay. So you're gonna marry him?
I'm gonna fuck Rishi Sunak.
Okay.
Because maybe bag over the head, ball gag, you could get through it. I don't know. Like he's got pillow princess energy. Spineless.
Oh my gosh.
He's just a tech bro.
Yeah.
He's like a weird person that just feels entitled to this life ruling over people. It's gonna be the worst lay of your life. Trump, you have to marry to just spectacularly divorce in the worst way possible.
Yeah.
To show his base that marriage has no sanctity and also just tried to ruin him financially. And then I think I'm taking one for the team.
I mean, he's already financially ruined, I think.
And that's my answer.
There we go.
All right, Phil, this one better be just as controversial. Here we go.
Okay.
What is the worst gift you've ever received?
Ooh.
Now it's time to offend someone, you know?
Okay.
All right, Phil's family, Phil's friends. I'm going to send this to whoever this is.
Dan.
Go on, Phil, tell the truth.
On a morning near Christmas, I'm like, Dan, you got me 3 presents. What is this? I opened the first one.
I got you like 4.
It is a dinosaur lamp.
The one that's in the background of your videos?
Yeah.
It's what you wanted.
It is what I wanted.
You wanted a cute thing to like go in the background of videos.
Yeah, I opened the second present. It's a mini lava lamp.
Okay, yes.
The third present, and it is a hippo lamp in the same style as the dinosaur lamp you bought me before. Dan, you got me 3 lamps.
No, stop.
You got me 3 lamps for Christmas. What the hell is wrong with you?
You asked for a lamp.
I asked for three lamps.
I am someone that is thoughtful and buys my Christmas presents early. So yeah. I bought the dinosaur lamp.
Right.
Then I saw a mini lava lamp and I
cheap
just thought,
crap.
That's like a mini gift.
Right.
And then the third lamp was because I forgot I bought the first lamp, but I knew I had a good idea. So I went to the same people that made like the origami lamps and I got you an origami hippo lamp that looked like the origami dinosaur lamp. And then I forgot and then I just wrapped them up and then I gave them to you.
Yeah.
And then you looked at me like, why are you so fucking weird? Why'd you give me three lamps?
Yeah. It was the Christmas
lamp. Sorry that I'm an amazing friend. Fuck your lamp. I'm gonna walk into your video background and take the dinosaur back.
I like it. It was like a whole
worst
troop.
Gift you've ever received.
It was a whole troop of lamps.
Sure.
How good are you at keeping secrets?
Ooh. I am literally the only person other than you.
Yeah.
That I think is capable of keeping a secret.
Really?
I've never trusted a bitch in my life.
Your friends are gonna watch this.
Yeah, and I'm talking to all of you motherfuckers.
Oh my God.
People love to gossip. It's like,
oh, I've got a girlfriend, and I tell her everything, so I told her.
Then no! The girlfriend's gonna say something.
I tell my mom everything. We speak on the phone every day.
No!
Okay, no. Well, to me, I can never trust you again.
Because that's like...
I'm taking you down a tier.
You can't tell
where
the thing.
I'll have a good time with you, but I can't, like, tell you things.
And you can't hint at the thing. You can't be like,
no.
Hey, Phil told me something I'm not allowed to tell you, but it's about
his butt. And I don't know
butt.
Why Dan could have trust issues, or just, like, a need to maintain privacy, but
yeah.
I will never tell a secret.
No.
If you tell me something, I will die with it. Because to me... The specialness of having a relationship with another person, like your friendship, your connection, is in that psychic knowledge.
So
and the moment you let that go,
you can't let it go,
the joy of your connection with the other person is soiled.
It's gone.
And I feel sorry for people that don't understand that.
Yeah.
Have you ever gotten detention, been suspended or expelled? No, he's Phil.
I got detention because...
You got detention?
Yeah, my friend bought a laser pen to school.
How often did you get detention?
Once.
You got detention once?
I got detention once.
Ever?
After school detention. It wasn't a lunchtime detention.
So
this was
traumatic.
This was a bad detention.
Drama. All right. It was a bad detention.
My friend brought a laser pen to school. And I was just playing with it. And then I shot it on my friend James Stevenson's leg. Right?
Were you pointing at his face?
No.
And you're lying
I
on
promise,
YouTube?
I promise. I'm not lying.
Okay, so you were playing with a laser pen and you pointed
swear.
It at his leg.
He freaked out. I was like, you're shining in my eyes. You get in my face. I was like, I'm not. I was just trying to test it on your leg. And he was like, you got me in the eyes. And I swear it was, you could see the red dot. Because I didn't want to show.
And then how did you get detention?
Then he went crying to a teacher.
What?
And told me and said that I had shiny laser pens.
What?
Not in his eye.
He just said, rat.
What he said is, Phil Lester's going around shining laser pens in everyone's eyes.
Oh. Firstly.
Ratted.
Firstly, the intention is misrepresented.
Yes.
Then the act is greatly exaggerated and then it becomes pluralized.
Yeah.
What a knock.
And then me and my friend Mark were in detention because he brought the laser pen to school. And what you had to do is just write lines. So they wrote a sentence on the board and you had to write it out over
like
and over
again.
Like
the Simpsons.
Yeah, like the Simpsons.
I just had to sit in silence.
Really?
You had to write lines.
Yeah, we had to write 100 lines.
That's so stupid.
I did a whole picture of Moose TV. So it was like a TV show presented by a moose. And it was really detailed. And the teacher walked over and saw it and then made me do an extra half an hour.
Well, yeah, because no shit. Your job was to write the lines, not to draw a Moose TV.
I didn't think he'd look at the lines. Naughty lad.
And oh my God. Right, I'm scared now.
Why?
Phil, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Because we are about to-
Wait, you need to do your very deepest voice.
We are about to go deeper.
Deeper. Wait.
Deeper.
Wait.
Deeper. Deeper. Deeper.
Oh, that wins. That wins.
Phil's got the deepest throat. What are these questions gonna be?
I'm scared. It's gonna-
Are we actually gonna discover things that we don't know?
Maybe.
Ooh. Is it gonna be deep psychoanalysis, trauma?
Have you ever murdered someone?
Okay, I'm ready, Phil. Hit me.
Oh, the card feels weighty in my hand.
I'm
like
ready.
Some kind of revelations are coming. How do you feel about... I read that wrong. How do you feel about... How do you feel about your education? Did it prepare you for real life?
Absolutely fucking not. What?
Why?
I went to the worst school ever. Firstly, school is rubbish. It don't tell you about taxes.
No.
Accounting. Contracts,
no.
How to get a job.
They don't teach you
cooking.
Any of that stuff.
There was a home economics class that they did at our school that was like 30 minutes once a week.
Yeah.
For just 2 years. That shit should have been half an hour a day.
I know.
Cooking is like most of life.
And we had to make cakes and there's only 6 ovens and 35 kids.
We did we had to make sandwiches.
What? Anyone can make a sandwich.
Well, that's exactly.
I've said this before, that the first day at uni after I'd met my friends, we walked to Asda together and I started crying in the cheese aisle when I realized, oh my fucking God, I don't know how to function. Yeah. I'm in an Asda.
You don't know what
anything
is.
And I have to spend like a budget on food for like a week?
Ingredients?
Why was I doing history, learning about the Magna Carta? Like,
what
I understand
life?
You need to know what an oxbow lake is.
Yes.
But also, some of this stuff is just like an intelligence critical thinking test, a memory test.
Most of school is a memory test. And do you think having an all-boys school was worse? You.
It is the most dystopian shit in the entire world.
I know.
And the children in my school were feral monsters that no one should have to be responsible for educating. But something about me is I am quite resentful of people that like went to good schools.
Okay.
Because I feel like if I had a better childhood, I could be a more intelligent, more well-rounded, happier, more functioning. I was in a battle royale for 10 years and now I'm traumatized.
Well, look at you now, you're functional and you know all the long words. Maybe too many long words.
Yeah, okay. The yapping should stopping. Phil, are you ready to reveal layers of depth? What do you consider to be red flags?
Ooh.
Here we go.
Red
Here
flags.
Here we go.
Okay.
Oh, Phil, what's gonna come out now?
It's my own heartthrob. Red flag one.
Okay, list.
This is not for introverts and shy people, but if you've been friends with someone—
But it totally is.
No,
so
no.
Strap in, losers.
If you've known someone for a while, and they've not asked you a single question about yourself.
Ooh, you hate that!
I hate that. Just ask me something about me. If I've been asking you, and I know some people are shy and they don't want to say anything, which is fine. I'm not talking about
you
guys.
If it's a social anxiety thing, it's okay.
Yeah.
But some people who are perfectly chatty and confident,
extroverted, chatty boxes, don't ask me anything.
Spend a whole evening getting to know someone, and you just have to reflect. Did that person ask you anything
did they care
about
yourself?
Like, did they care? Yeah.
At all?
I think a lot of people don't pick up on that or question that, but you do.
I do.
And when you point that out to me about people that we've met, I'm like, are they an asshole? They, like, what the hell? That,
it's
very right. Because, you know, sometimes I count myself as like the awkward person that doesn't think about things.
Yeah.
I now, because of Phil telling me this red flag, which I already knew, so I guess the game here failed, is I'm like, oh my God, have I asked that person? I'm like, what's your favorite Pringle flavor? Where'd you grow up?
That's all you need.
Tell me.
Red flag two, overcorrectors. Who gives a shit? If someone's telling a story, right? And you've told the most amazing story and then someone goes, actually, I think it was a red bus in The Dark Knight Rises. It's like,
no,
that doesn't matter what I was talking
Jake,
about.
No one gives a fuck.
No one cares.
Literally no one fucking cares.
I think we went on a Thursday. It wasn't a Tuesday. Why are you quizzing me on this? I'm just telling you a story.
Do you not know how to have fun?
No.
Do you not know that life's a performance and that sometimes you need to not break the fourth wall?
So that is one of my icks. The last one is one-uppers. If you're telling something, they're like, oh, I've done that better. That's a bad sign.
I did that too in New Zealand.
Okay. I mean, it's fine if you've got a better story, but you don't need to just like do it every single time.
Have tact.
Have a bit.
Have grace.
Tact.
Well, that was a good one. Okay, we're actually having deep conversations here. You got a problem?
Dan, what do you think is the worst age to be and why?
Ooh. 150 because you're dead.
Maybe.
The worst age is 14, hands down. Specifically.
Yeah, it's
complete disaster.
It's confusing. You're like, am I a child?
Puberty,
am I a teenager? What
hormone,
am I?
Like sexual feelings, maybe contending with what that means emotionally and society's like idea of the molds that you're supposed to go into.
Yeah.
School's probably terrible. Your friends are probably a disaster. All these expectations for you. And I think that's what it is. Like the reality of being 14, I think would be fine if the world didn't make being 14 such like an uncomfortably observed experience.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It was stressful.
It's like, let a 14-year-old just do their thing on an island and they'll be fine. Phil, this is the final question in this quest.
Okay.
Describe one thing about you that is misunderstood by your friends.
Ooh,
okay. This is gonna make the next Wingspan night at Dan and Phil's awkward. Here we go.
What is misunderstood by my friend? Growing up, a lot of people thought I was shy. If we go out for like a dinner with 6 people, I'm probably the person talking the most. for the whole evening.
You carry, I carry
the conversation.
Every single evening, Phil does all of the conversations, all the icebreakers. Phil is 800 of these in his brain at any given moment.
Yeah. Do you think it's
I think
now?
That you have this, like, kind energy.
Yes.
Some people take your lack of being, like, an asshole as, oh, he's just, like, quiet and shy. And not only is that, like, an insult to you.
Yes.
But it's an insult to me having to deal with who you actually are.
I am an introvert, so I'll go home after being
and be like,
chatty.
Don't talk
and
I'll be like, to me for a
month. Right, I'm just going
to
recharge. But then it really irks me if offhandedly someone will be like, well, yeah, but you're really shy, aren't you? I'm like, I'm just nice.
Phil's had a Coke Zero and 3 Tangs Fastix. He's about to do a backflip.
And they'll say something as well like, how did you go on stage and do a show when you're so shy? It's like, where's this?
Like, what are
why
you
doing? Not-
maybe you just need to be more of a and then people will, like, respect you.
Yeah.
Now the question is, I'm sure that was lovely and interesting for you guys. What did we not know about each other here?
Lamps you forgot, the worst
I
gift.
Repressed the lamps. Yeah. I remember the incident.
Did you know about my laser pen detention?
I did not know your laser pen story.
Moose TV.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, is that getting to know you or is that just, like, get filed in the Phil's wacky northern childhood memory bowl? You didn't know about my scene kid bowl haircut
I didn't.
Incident.
I really want to see it. So we know each other too well. That's it. Hopefully you learned something new though.
Yeah, this was good though.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, we are professional yappers and yet this enabled some fun chats.
It did. Chatting and yapping. So
I'd love to do this at 4 a.m. with the girlies.
Yeah. So let's get deep. If you want
to check
it out, you can click the link below, grab the game,
it
get to know your
make
friends.
You say...
Then Hinge still, oh my God.
You know, safe for grandma. Grandma edition. Are we silk pajama people now? This is luxurious as hell. Like, it's nice on the skin. The nips are being caressed.
Yes, side tangent. Dan, paperback.
Yeah, my book about how to sort your goddamn life out is being re-released thinner and cheaper than ever before.
Ooh. If you don't know, Dan wrote a book that could actually change your life.
People like it. Like, I feel a bit embarrassing promoting this book sometimes. But
don't
it's
be.
Like,
be proud of it.
You all need to read it. I reread it all the goddamn time.
Mm.
I forced Phil to listen to the audiobook.
I did.
Because he was nagging me about feeling anxious and I was like, bitch, I wrote a book about this.
It helps. There's even bonus chapters, isn't there?
There's new material about things like how to cope with uncertainty in the world. It's a terrifying place to be.
Lovely.
You can get it from anywhere. And if you want to go to my shop.danielhowell.com, you can get it signed. I will be going with a Sharpie. Yes, there will be left-handed smudges. No refunds. Thank
Prime
you.
Prime your wrist. Okay, it's the end screen. It's time to go to sleep.
Let us know in the comments what you think about our answers to these questions and what your answers to some of these. I want to see spicy takes. I want to see controversial answers. I want to see wacky anecdotes from your unbelievable childhoods.
That would be lovely.
Give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe for more
mayhem.
Pajama time with Dan and Phil. That's weird.
That is weird.
Bye.
Bye.